Right, hello and welcome back. As I said in my last video, today we're going to be doing the contract job of the swimming pool downtown. So let's have a look at that, and let's accept that contract. And let's have a look what we need to do first. So excavation, let's have a quick run through of what we need to do. Excavation, and we'll get materials delivered to site. Not many materials there. And you pour the slab foundation and pour the concrete walls. Okay, let's get started with this. So let's have a look where we need to go first here. So let's jump into the not lorry. We need to jump into the excavator. And then first thing we're gonna do is fast travel to the gas station, and then we can repair the excavator and fill out with fuel as well, because they're both getting pretty low. That also goes towards making myself a large company. I'm pretty sure large. Alright. Go in. Let's have a good look. We should, I thought we could. Obviously not. Refuel there, get that full up, and let's repair our excavator. That's the expensive bit, 13,000. So let's now fast travel over to the construction site and let's get this job started. As we found out on our mini job, this excavator is quite a large one, so it shouldn't take too long. Unless it's a ginormous swimming pool, which I doubt it is. Done in no time. Right, let's have a look where we are. Okay. Okay, so we're on the side of the house. Get excavation. Start the back here. Back in there, shall we? Okay. Okay, like I said before, it'll only let you dig as far down as you need to. So when you get to that depth, you'll just stop collecting dirt then. Before then you can actually collect enough dirt there. Not bad. Start to wreck the house in the process. Start dumping the dirt somewhere else. We are running out of room. Dump it over the neighbor's garden. Yeah, we can. Just disappears there. Nice. The neighbors won't mind. No. Put some of their gutter in too. Block up their gutter in. Why not? In the world, but that is what our helper is there for. Clean up after us, thanks for that. Let's make it nice and neat. Which I'll show you once we're done. Thank you. Now we need to clear the marked area and get out of here. Okay, so we'll take our excavator back to our yard because we do not need that any longer. And then we will get our truck. We won't take our lorry, we don't need that. So we will just take the flatbed with crane on the back, jump into that. So there is our job site. So get to the material dealer and pick up the materials we need. Come here, so I forget where I think to park here, and then we get into and we can get it delivered straight onto our truck. So a pallet of wood, a pallet of revarnish, and a pallet of concrete framework. Okay, so we can filter that too, just some materials we need for our job. Then we go out to checkout, and then press square to auto load and purchase that. Not suitable transport for this vehicle. Okay. Maybe we should have bought the lorry. Should we do that? No, what should we take off? If we take off the rebar mesh, that we'd come back for that. There we go. I think we should have fitted on there, but apparently not. So let's now fast travel our way over to the job site. It's a lot quicker than driving, so why not? Then what we can do, we can get the rebar mesh hopefully deliver straight to site then, while we're once we're already there. And there's the crane there to move it. If we move out of the way, all the way to here, and we go back to the material site. And go check out and delivery. Deliver straight to construction site. Okay, so that should be I bought that and I don't see it. This is our construction site. That should already be here. But it's over here, is it? Oh, come on, get up. There we go. Yeah, there it is. Okay. Yeah, that's fine, so we'll jump back into our crane. Get those two offloaded. And then we'll go around and pick up the pallet of concrete mesh. Get that set down there. Try not to hit the house on our way around. Spin that around. Okay, that's set down. Okay, so now let's go and get the pad of concrete mesh. We'll do all of this into there. Up on the road. Right. Sorry about that. I'll fix the sign later, no worries. Right. Up a pad of rebar mesh. Alright. Load those onto our truck. And get those put down where they need to go. Let's drive that round. I don't know why that car couldn't go around me. Impossible, obviously. Let's go further. There we go. Alright, let's change mode and get this unloaded. Then we can get to pouring the concrete. Quicker than that. Evening, noon, morning. So back and come back and it's the morning, there we are. Okay. So what we will do, jump back into our frame, take that back to our yard and grab the pump, concrete pump, and concrete mixer. And get that concrete slab poured. Slab foundation poured. Okay, so we will get our pump on site first. Get that all set up and then we will come back for our mixer. Right, we're on site now. So I think what I'll do, I'll just set up our crane here. We're close enough that we should be able to reach. I will just check now. So, jump into our mixer and get our mixer on site too. And let's get going. Let's fast travel back to here. So, fill up the concrete and start pouring. Jump back into our concrete pump. Let's go. Nicely done, thank you. Right, let's pour our walls now. Stop there. Jumps into the mixer there. Got that component. And let's speak to our site foreman. Simple as that, came along nicely. Looking good. Okay, and that is another job complete. Again, thanks for watching.